I'm at the Tunstall store. They're from Green Page. They're from Swamico.
Nice meeting you.
Yeah, nice meeting you.
Look for, I think it's like maybe 30 spots in them. Yeah, it's even better.
Yes.
Yeah. I prefer that.
This is only your second year.
Oh, really? That's brand new.
New.
Yeah. I was in one for a while. It must have been 500 campers.
Look at those cars. Shoot the flashes on.
It's pretty good. Thursday, every afternoon on Thursday.
I'm about to put this on YouTube to free up some space on my phone. I've been taking so many pictures.
And a lot of people full time are staying there all the time. I mean, they have porches built, you know, under their fifth wheels.
This cash register.
Yeah.
Sometimes the cows would even need it.
Yeah. And now a lot of them had golf carts.
Yep. That's what played my brother.
Yeah. They would run round, all hours of the dadgum night playing the radios, but they didn't play them too loud.
Right. That's the
but,
thing.
But they did up until about 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
And you can hear
four or five
parties going every night from Thursday to Sunday. All weekend. Didn't bother me. I didn't attend. I didn't know any of those people. And they didn't bother me. But I would get so tickled because they would come by and they would stop and then they'd have the two damn carts, one going into the woman, and they'd stop, they'd talk to you, and they'd be going, you know.
Socialize here.
Yeah.
That flash is messing with her.
They were having a ball, living a life.
Yep.
You got a trace.
As long as they're not bothering their neighbors, nobody cares.
You know, right. Exactly.
That was the deal.
As long as they're behaving.
Well, they were all hired.
Mail truck.
Mail truck, yeah, they come through here. He's actually running late.
Look at that Wisconsin plate right there.
She's right here.
Yeah, that's me.
She's Green Bay.
That's my car, Wisconsin.
Oh,
Green Bay. Go
back. Small world.
I know. It's crazy.
I'm telling you, a while ago, I had two families in here from Orange County, California, and then the two families in here from Wisconsin. Three, I guess.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Right now?
Yes.
That is
right.
Look at those prices. How funny. So many people from Wisconsin.
Well, you're right.
And you guys are getting 8 to 10 inches of snow today. And it's sunny and beautiful here. Look at all these old period pieces.
Socialize all day.
It's a museum. You can't buy anything here. Everything's preserved.
Man, we get people in here from all over.
That's
that guy here, you were came from some island nation. My wife will tell you right off the bat. I talked about it.
Oh, I wanted to see this room really quick.
Here's
Tunstall's living quarters.
Yeah.
Oh, my eyes have to adjust. Wow. Look at that. Crazy. Look at that. The floor is open right there. Look at those floorboards.
I've been worried about that for 25 years.
I love to caused us to read it.
That strong, it looks like it would be something that they would have stored.
They could have.
Rain and stuff up above.
They, well, of course, it was dirt up there about that thick. And that's pretty heavy.
Yes.
And then they put that, that gable roof on it after the fact. Well, it's part of the story. James Dolan, who owned that house over there, who was the impetus who got this mess started. He killed this guy. He sold him the property. Dolan sold Tunstall, or he sold it to McSween. And Tunstall built this building here. Dolan killed him and ended up with it back with the improvements on it, which is kind of interesting. But in fact, he's the one who put the roof, the gable roof on. He built the porches out here. Added a third room.
So he wants this all on a bank contract so that if anything happened to the owner died and couldn't pay him back, he got the building back.
Well, no, that would have been thinking. Now this was just pure out there.
Sure,
no.
The way they got it.
Because there's fellows up our way that they would sell land contracts and that it was something that people couldn't afford to stay on the property.
Yeah, and then get it back. Yeah.
They get it back
and sell it again.
And sell it again.
Well, yeah, that has happened with the cottage.
They got to be rich ones by just reselling stuff that.
Well, what happened here? After that Lincoln County War, Mrs. McSween was the last owner of the building because everybody else was dead. She sold it to Dolan's wife. She got a bid from a guy named George Pickett who built almost all the buildings in this town. He did not build this one, he built that one. And see, he said it would cost, I think it was $1,119.60. Put this building back into shape so she could reopen the business. She didn't have the money. She sold it to Mrs. Dolan for $1,119. 2 years later, she died with him in her will, and that's how he got it back. Still, I tell people, he sold them the property and killed him, got it back. You know, that real thing.
Horseshoes.